Hello viewers, welcome to the lecture series of financial accounting. Today we shall take up unit 2nd of financial accounting and we'll discuss consignment accounting. It is first part of consignment accounting and we will learn the special accounting of consignment under this lecture. We will discuss in detail what consignment is all about, what is the accounting involved and what are the peculiar features of consignment. So today's lecture shall cover introduction to the consignment, meaning, its features and computation of commission. We know that under consignment there are several sort of commissions which are being given to the consignee. So as we will move ahead, we will learn all the calculation aspect concerned with the commission which is being payable to the consignee. So let's move to the first segment of our discussion, that is meaning of consignment. Consignment account deals with a situation where one person sends goods to another person on the basis that goods will be sold on behalf of or at the risk of the former. So here we want to say that it is a special accounting where goods of one person is being sent to another person and the purpose might be warehousing of those goods and which ultimately leads to selling of the goods. Since nowadays the expansion of the business has been there, there is a development and industrialization. So in order to sell the goods at different places, the concept of consignment has come into existence, where one person transfers his goods to another person, not for the object of selling, but with the ultimate objective of selling. So how we will differentiate it? Let us learn it. Here dispatch of goods is being done from the one person to another for the purpose of warehousing and ultimately leading to sales. Here purpose of warehousing means that the ownership is not being transferred. Then what has happened? Let us understand it. Only possession is being transferred and not the ownership. Such transactions are known as consignment transaction, meaning thereby that the ultimate owner of the goods remain consignor, but consignee is selling those goods on behalf of the person who has sent those goods. So there are two parties being involved, one who has sent the goods and one who has received the goods. The receiver of the goods is not the owner of the goods, he is selling it on behalf of the person who has sent the goods. So what's benefit to that person? That person is receiving remuneration for his services, and that service which he has rendered for dispatching of the goods is considered to be commission which is being payable to him. So the receiver of the goods will receive not the profit but the commission amount. So this is the peculiar characteristic of consignment transaction. So here two parties are being involved, consignor and consignee. Who is consignor? The one who initiates the goods, that means where the initial point is there, the sender of the goods, who is owner of the goods, is considered to be the consignor, while the person who sells those goods on behalf of the consignor is known as consignee. So here again one more important thing is that these goods are under the ownership of consignor, however they are being possessed by consignee who sell them to the customers. So we have already discussed that these are the parties being involved. Consignor is the sender, consignee is the receiver of the goods. So the consignor and consignee are in the relationship of principal and agent. When we have discussed in business law that agency relationships are there, the same sort of relation of principal and agent is being involved under consignment accounting. Now let us learn essential features of consignment. Firstly, there is a principal. The party which sends goods is called consignor or principal. Second is the agent. The party to whom goods are sent is called consignee or agent. It is very clear that the two parties being involved are consignor and consignee, and they are in the relationship of principal and agent. The next important feature of the consignment is that it is not a sale, as only possession of the goods is changed. The meaning of this phrase Possession and not ownership is transferred, means that all the risk and the rewards associated with the goods shall be borne by consignor himself. Meaning thereby that if a consignor who is residing in Delhi has transferred his goods to the consignee residing in Bombay, so whatever risk and reward which are associated with the goods which has started from the initiation point of Delhi by the consignor, such risk and rewards associated with the goods will remain with the consignor. However, only dispatch of the goods will be by the consignee at another end. Now, here risk and reward means that if any damage is there to the goods, such damage will be borne by consignor. Rewards here means that if the goods are being transferred above the invoice price, again the profits earned will be that of the consignor because he is the owner of the goods. However, the possession is only being given to the consignee. Now, one more thing here we would like to highlight is that difference between invoice and cost. Cost shall be the cost at which the goods are being manufactured, but when they are being consigned, they will be consigned either at cost or cost plus the profit so involved. When profit is being loaded to the cost, it is called invoice. So when such goods are being transferred, that means when the consignee is holding the goods at invoice, he is not having the profits with him, the profit will be carried with the consignor only as he is the owner. Next important feature is that performa invoice. Now, what is performa invoice? It is the crucial document under consignment. Principal does not send an invoice to the agent. Principal here means consignor. He sends only a performa invoice, which is like an invoice but not really one. It provides information regarding particulars of the goods sent. So what happens that the consignor sends a detailed analysis of the goods, the quality, quantity, specification which are being associated with the goods so sent to the consignee. However, it is different from invoice because invoice is generated at the time when actual sales takes place. Here the actual sales is not taking place, only the possession is being transferred. So it helps as a source document to identify the detailed description of the goods. Invoice is being generated when the amount gets due at the time of sales. So performa invoice is different from the bill or invoice so generated, and it is being sent by the principal to its agent. Now the next important feature is account sales. It is also a statement which is being prepared under consignment accounting. It is the statement which shows sales so made and the amount of expenses incurred by the consignee. Now, at one end we have talked about performa invoice which was being given by the consignor. Now, account sale is being prepared by consignee and it will show the amount of sales so made plus any expenditure. That means total sales less expenditure he will show which he has incurred. We can say that it is the statement prepared by consignee having all details of sales so made and expenses so incurred up to the time he received goods, and such account is sent to the consignor. So what happens that there is a format to prepare account sales where sales will be given at the top, then we will write less expenditures. The expenditure can be of carriage, freight or any other related expenditure. Then we will subtract if any advance which is being received by the consignee from the consignor, and the net amount which is being due to the consignee from the consignor is being depicted under account sales. So on the basis of the account sales, consignee will get his payments from the consignor. Again, very important it is for the calculation of commissions also, because under account sales entire information in relation to the sales and expenditure will be narrated. The next important point is expenses. Expenses are all those necessary expenditure which is being done by the consignee for the dispatch of the goods, but these expenses will not be incurred out of the pocket of consignee because he is agent of the sender of the goods. So, he will get its reimbursement. So, let us learn what is being said over here. The agent recovers from the principal all expenses incurred by him on the consignment. This can be changed by agreement between two parties. The two parties are consignor and consignee. If they mutually decided to share some of the expenditure, they can do so provided they have an agreement for the same. Now, these expenses can be of two types, direct and indirect. Direct expenses are all those expenses which are being necessary to bring the consignment to the place of consignee. That means freight, octroi, carriage inward, all these expenditures are considered to be direct expenses. Now, what are indirect expenses? The maintenance expenses which have incurred to keep the goods into the warehouse, that means rentals, electricity, whichever has been apportioned on those goods would be considered as indirect expenses. Now, what's the need of segregating these two expenses? There is obvious need of segregating the expenses into two categories, direct and indirect, because it's not necessary that entire goods so sent will be disposed of. Some of the goods may remain unsold. So, that shall form the part of closing stock. When we value the closing stock at the end of the transactions or at the end of the period which has been decided between consignor and consignee, at that time the valuation of the closing stock is to be done. So, direct expenses shall form the part of closing stock in the proportionate manner. That is why there is a need of segregation of expenses into two categories, and the computational aspect of closing stock is very essential to ascertain profit or loss which arise out of the consignment agreements. So, let us read what has been said over here. These expenses can be direct or indirect. The direct expenses shall form part of value of closing stock which is being left out. That means it is being left out from sales. It has not been sold out. To value closing stock, proportionate direct expenses shall be added to the value of closing stock. Crucial part of the consignment is commission. We know that when the consignee is not the owner of the goods and he is selling the goods on behalf of the consignor, there is a remuneration being payable to the consignee, and this remuneration is termed as commission. Now, what shall be the base for finding out this commission which is being payable to the consignee? Obviously, the turnover. Now, there can be variation to ascertain this commission. Let us understand what do we mean by commission which is being computed under consignment. It is the part of the remuneration payable to the consignee for selling the goods on consignment. Such commission will be percentage of total turnover, because that is the base to ascertain commission. The consignee is disposing of the goods of consignor. So, if he has disposed of goods of 10,000 and 10% is the commission rate, he will get a commission of 1,000 on such disposing of the assets or goods which is being sent by the consignor. So, depending upon the agreement between consignor and consignee, the rate of commission will be decided and it will be payable to the consignee. It will be income of consignee and a expenditure of the consignor. These commissions can be of three types mainly: simple commission, overriding commission and del credit commission. Simple commission, as the name suggests, it will be computed on the gross turnover. Overriding means above certain thing. So, we will discuss how it is being computed. It is above the simple commission, and del credit commission is a commission which is being paid to the consignee for taking up some extra risk. So, one by one we will learn about them. Simple commission is being computed in the manner where invoice price is being multiplied by rate of commission. Invoice price will be the price at which the goods are being sold That means the gross turnover shall be the value of simple commission. Now the next one is overriding commission. Overriding means additional percentage of commission on account of sales so made over the invoice price. Commission on sales above invoice price shall be payable. Here we want to say that if the invoice price is 60 rupees and whatever has been paid above 60 rupees on that units into the rate, we will get the amount of the turnover on which an additional percentage of commission will be given to the consignee. Now, Dell credit commission. Consignee owns the risk of bad debts on the amount of credit sales. So, where there is a credit sale, or it might be possible the entire sales is credit sales. So, wherever we are able to ascertain that this is credit sale, on those sales, rate of commission is being decided as Dell credit commission, and the consignee would be getting additional commission as Dell credit commission on the disposing of the goods on credit. So, we will take up an example and understand how this commission can be computed under different scenarios. Mr. A of Bombay has consigned 2000 sets to Mr. B of Jaipur. Out of such goods consigned to him, he sold 1500 units. The cost price of the radio is 50 rupees per set, while the invoice price is 60. So, goods are being sold out at rupees 60. Now, a bifurcation is given how these 1500 units are being sold by B, so that we can ascertain the amount of commission. So, we will write up the subdivision of 1500 units, that how they are being sold, and we will assume the rates of commission as 5% for additional that is overriding commission. We will assume the rate to be 1% extra and Dell credit commission to be 0.5%. Here is a particulars being given for the 1500 units which are being sold by the consignee at Jaipur. He has sold 500 units at the invoice price of 60 and the sales amount is 30,000. 200 units above the invoice price, that is at 75, it amounts to 200 into 75, 15,000. 400 units again at 75, which amounts to 30,000. And 400 units again at 80 rupees per unit, it amounts to 32,000. So, our total sale is 1,07,000. Just assume that this all is being on credit. Now, the computational aspect we need to see. First of all, simple commission is to be ascertained. So, 1500 units are being sold. When simple commission is being computed, we know that invoice price into the rate of percentage is being applied. So, we here assume the rate of simple commission to be 5%. Invoice price is 60. And the total units being sold is 1500. So, 1500 into 60 into 5% will give us the figure of simple commission to be 4500. Now, overriding commission. Overriding commission is being given on the sales which is being made above the invoice price of rupees 60. If we go back to the previous slide and see that except 500 units at 60, all sale is being made above the invoice price of 60. So, if we add a 15,000, 30,000 and 32,000, we will get the figure of sales and it amounts to 77,000. This 77,000 amount of sale is we will use to ascertain overriding commission at the rate of 1%. So, we will get the figure of overriding commission to be 770 rupees. Now comes Dell credit commission. It is being given on the amount of credit sales. Now, the Dell credit commission is to be computed. We know that Dell credit commission is being given when the consignee owns additional responsibility of bad debts. So, bad debts would be associated with credit sales. And in our given example, we will assume that this entire sale is on credit sales. So, the total figure of sales, that is 30,000, 15,000, 30,000 and 32,000, adding it up, we are getting the total sales figure to be 1,07,000. So, Dell credit commission is to be computed on this total sales which we assume to be credit sales, and we will get the figure as We have assumed here that Dell credit commission is 0.5% of the total sales so made. So 1,07,000 into 0.5% will give us the figure of Dell credit commission to be 535. So in all, the total commission which is being payable to the consignee, that is Mr. B of Jaipur, will be 4,500 plus 770 plus 535, and it will be the aggregate amount of rupees 5,805 rupees. So this is the computational aspect of commission. We have covered up all sort of commission calculations which will be useful to us when we will solve any practical question in relation to the consignment. Now, here we end up the computational aspect and basic features of the consignment. Then we will move ahead in our next lecture. We will learn about the books of accounts to be maintained in the books of consignor and in the books of consignee. That how consignment accounting will be done at both the ends. We will learn how to prepare consignment account. Under consignment account, we will ascertain profits and losses so made. If there is any closing stock, its valuation and reserves is to be ascertained. All this calculation aspect will be covered in our upcoming lecture. Now students, we will summarize our discussion on consignment which we have done today. Under today's discussion, we have learned the meaning of consignment. And we have appreciated its meaning by understanding the definition that it is an agreement or arrangement of principal and agent between the consignor and consignee, where consignor's goods are being transferred to the consignee. And the one important phrase which we have learned is that possession is being transferred and not the ownership, and all the risks and rewards associated with the goods with the consignor only. Then we have learned all the peculiar features associated with consignment, that is principal and agent relationship, expenses, how expenses are being segregated so that closing stock can be valued accordingly. Then we have learned in detail about account sales and performa invoice, as well as the calculation aspect of commission, which is a remuneration to the consignee, and it is being computed in three ways: simple commission, and overriding commission, and Dell credit commission. We have learned their calculation in detail. With this, we are ending up our session of today. Hopefully, there had been a happy learning. Thank you.